Hey everybody, this is Perch, and we're talking about, in this case, a manga called Sakura Diaries, but more kind of the romance drama kind of category of manga, which is, so this is a funny one. First off, I want to just acknowledge that there's a lot of context that's going to get left behind in a quick 10-minute video about a manga. And if you're a big fan of Sakura Diaries, coming into this, maybe you saw the title, you got excited by it. You're probably going to be disappointed because I'm going to stay at a very surface level. I'm going to attempt to not spoil big aspects of the manga, but there will be some spoilers. So if you're listening along and you're thinking, this is something I want to listen, I would like to read this, you might want to bow out at some point and just take care of it. But in no way is this video trying to capture exactly what this series is, because it's got a lot of twists and turns. Just as we start to go through it, you'll see a little bit of what I'm talking about. But the other thing I want to accomplish in this video is to talk a little bit about this romance category, and in particular acknowledge that at times people have said, I'm interested in kind of romance type, slice of life, relationship, romantic comedy kind of comics, manga. It is a category that, particularly in the US, is underserved. There's definitely an interest in it. However, if you go to manga for it, you might not get exactly what you want. And that's because their definition of romantic comedy is often highly different from what in the US you would describe as romantic comedy. So Sakura Diaries, a couple things out the gate. This is written and illustrated by Yujin. Yujin is the kind of the artist name, the mangaka artist. And he is, depending on who you ask, he would be a pinup type artist or a lewd type artist, depending on kind of where you sit in that category. But both of those descriptions, I think, are very inaccurate, or at least it leaves a lot on the table. Yujin is amazing in composition and putting together really nice pages. And if you pick up Sakura Diaries or Sakura Chushin, you are going to, you know, if you're picking it up for porn reasons, you're going to be highly disappointed. Or rather, if you're looking for hentai, there's much quicker, much faster ways to go with it. I think I mentioned it before, there's a comic called Cheers, which is it's going to give you a lot more bang for your buck, so to speak. That's probably the worst possible way to tie. But I mean, there you're getting chapters of like 12 pages, and at least six of those 12 pages are going to be porn. So Sakura Diaries, Sakura Chuchin is definitely going to not give you that much. But Yujin does definitely know how to draw very classic, I'd say, women characters, particularly if you like kind of the manga style from the 90s, that kind of era. Very, very nice imagery and very good composition. You look at this stuff and just like the detail put into buildings and background characters and everything else is off the chart. So Yujin is definitely an artist to take a look at, definitely somebody to kind of note. And again, if you're describing him as a hentai artist or a porn artist, I think you're doing that artist a massive disservice. He's done a ton of different work, definitely some that is more sexy than others. But in general, that he's a very high quality artist. So Sakura Diaries is fundamentally, it's the adventures of a guy who is living a lie. And so, at a very basic summary, he really desires to get into a prestigious university. It's kind of that, definitely that sort of slice of life part comes in. This is picking up on the quest for Japanese men in particular to get into good universities and the struggle of how hard it is to get into a good university. And there's a lot of little aspects about this series that give you at least a sense of kind of life in Japan, the dedication to study, kind of the extreme limits that can go, cram schools and entrance exams and a lot of that kind of material. You shouldn't watch this anime or read this manga and assume that you're going to completely understand Japanese culture. That would be crazy, but it will give you a decent sense of certain aspects of how school works and other things that are different from the U.S. So that's a nice aspect to it. So our plot revolves around Toma, and Toma is trying to get into Keio University, Keio being one of the top universities, And it, you know, or depending on who you talk to in Japan, that's an interesting, by the way, side note that there's high debate about what the top universities are in Japan, usually based on the person arguing what university they got into. That's usually where the argument stems from. But anyway, he's about to take his entrance exams. It's a high pressure moment. He's very stressed. And up to his kind of his room comes a strange call girl who basically shows up and, you know, is going to make him happy. He doesn't quite understand this, but the next day he goes and he gets ready for his entrance exam, and he immediately falls in love with a redhead named Mieko. And, you know, the results for the exam come in, and the romantic love of his life, the woman he's dedicating himself to, he's making these vows like, that's the woman for me. That's the you are the person I'm going after. I'm going after her. So she gets into KO, but Toma does not. He fails. So not wanting to look ashamed, he pretends that he got into the school. And so this premise of the relationship's built on a lie. Meanwhile, he needs someplace to stay, and he lives with his cousin Urara, who is the call girl from the night before. She is basically has a crush on Toma, and she is dedicating her life to him. She is completely in love, smitten. It's very much a Japanese manga or anime trope where the girl is hopelessly smitten. The guy treats her like absolute garbage, but she sticks with him anyway. And so that's a lot of kind of the entry part of this series. You have Toma, who is trying to get with Mieko, and you have Urara, who's trying to get with Toma. And she'll do all kinds of crazy things, as well as some of the, you know, the pinup or sexy type of artwork comes in, because like Urara will dress up in like an apron and nothing else, and tries to constantly tempt Toma. But at the same time, part of the weird charm, now granted, you do have to overlook the fact that these are cousins, so you do get a Superman, Supergirl from the 60s kind of vibe going on here. That's just weird. But they kind of half try and explain this as, you know, distant cousins or other things later, but it's still cousins. I mean, let's not forget about that. But Urara is also faking. She is nowhere near as experienced with sex or with romance as she's letting on. And so this whole that's kind of the crux of how this whole thing goes. Now, the title then kind of spins out with a number of different side quests and other things. I mean, Toma, despite being a bit of a loser, does wind up sleeping with just about everybody who shows up. Although he has to work really hard to get to it, but there's also some pretty rough stuff in this. And this is where people who are looking at this as a happy romantic comedy, I think, are first going to be thrown by the fact that these two are cousins, but then are also going to be thrown by the fact that as you get further and further into this manga, there's the girls join an escort service. There is they deal with pretty significant violence and rape and lack of pregnancy, and I mean just some crazy stuff goes on in this that is pretty brutal. You definitely get some really uncomfortable, really graphic violence throughout all this. So that goes back to the, I think a lot of people try and get into manga, and they're looking for kind of romance or romantic comedy. And if you're coming to this title thinking I'm getting a lighthearted kind of almost, you know, Scott Pilgrim style romantic comedy slice of life thing, you are not. You're going to get something a lot more uncomfortable to read. And I'm not just talking about the incest, but just, you know, people trying to run each other over with cars and knife each other. And I mean, people are stabbed in the back. I mean, there's plenty of big violence here. And lots of twists and turns and relationships that form and are broken and kind of everything else. But all that said, there is an aspect to this series, among many others, where you are getting a interesting kind of cultural look into kind of ways that things are different in Japan. So I mean, and the art is gorgeous. And no, I'm not just talking about the pervy parts of it, because again, 95% of this book is not going to be pervy. It's going to be really nice illustrations. Again, Eugen is a terrific artist, so there's some really, really nice stuff coming out here and everything else. There is an anime, but the anime does a really, I would say, very poor job of adapting everything. It doesn't adapt the whole series. It adapts really kind of the beginning of it. The manga ran from 95 to 2000. And it is one of those cases where the manga wraps up rather abruptly. It definitely had the feel of this manga could have gone for another 10, 20 volumes, but the artist or the creator got tired. And so you get kind of this tacked on ending of kind of how everything gets wrapped up in the end. So spoilers, the cousins do get back into a relationship. They do end as in a relationship. And so if you're rooting, this title is weird because as I read this, this series, you think to yourself the whole time, this is gross, but you do find yourself weirdly rooting for this couple to make it, which is very odd. That's like the only way to put it. Very, very odd, but that they do kind of come together in the end and no pun intended. Anyway, so a couple things here. Sakura Diaries, again, definitely some pervy stuff, but more than that, some pretty violent, you know, tough stuff to kind of watch and deal with. An angry drunken client, physically beating up Urura badly. And that's very tough to look at. Beyond that, some very nice page, some very interesting kind of look inside of this other aspect, this other genre. I mean, again, romantic comedy, no. Sex comedy, no. Maybe, I don't know, a rough slice of life. I'm not sure what it is. It did run in Weekly Young Sunday, that magazine. So it's an interesting book. It's one, I think knowing Eugene and kind of learning about his art is an interesting one. And Sakura Diaries did have some popularity in it, as I mentioned, because of the manga and other pieces. And I think there's like a video game that was a dating sim as well, put out this. And anyway, it's an interesting, very interesting series, very polarizing because some people really can't get over the cousins aspect of it. And some people just find the whole relationship extremely charming. It is a weird series in that it is simultaneously kind of very innocent and cute and charming. And then also the complete opposite of that in one. If you've read this, this book, you know exactly what I mean. Anyway, so there's a title you probably haven't heard before, but an interesting one to check out. If what I've said disgusts you, certainly don't, because you're going to get more than you bargained for. Certainly some stuff I've left out. But if, it's also perhaps one to look at and, anyway, interesting. Let me know if you've read this title, in the comments below. If not, again, and if you're sitting here going, I do not understand any of this, gross, then what are you doing? Don't read it. It's not going to get better. Thanks for